at Oxton, she rides side saddle and goes away to hounds.
Twickenham is shrouded in fog when the King meets the varsity rugger teams. As the men of Oxford are presented, His Majesty, as a Cambridge man himself, may be hoping that the light blues will watch Obolensky, number two, Oxford's brilliant right wing. This, in fact, they do, but their anxiety on this score allows the dark blues to seize opportunities on the left, as, for instance, when Cook gets over to score their second try. Brett, the captain, converts. The Oxford tackling is very sound, and as soon as Cambridge start a run, the dark blues stop it. The second half scoring is all Oxford's, bar a Cambridge dropped goal, and their 17-4 win, added to boat race and cricket victories, makes 1937 an outstanding year for them. Here's a nice piece of work, resulting in a try by Mayhew. Adrian Quist meets John Bromwich far side in the men's singles final at Sydney.